Debugging your code on Kubernetes can be quite challenging, so Tanzu Application Platform has some things that can help with that. Let's go through a scenario where my QA folks have told me that there's a problem with my app. Every time they click this dummy sensor button, it blows up, and yeah, I've just confirmed that, it definitely blows up. So let's see if we can debug it. First of all, I'm going to have a quick look on the Kubernetes logs because obviously I've got full Kubernetes available to me. And as I scroll through, I can see, oh yeah, it's the application sensor data. There's something happening there, null pointer exception. So let's take a look at the code. I'll set a breakpoint on this code, and then we can go and have a look at it while it's running on the Kubernetes platform. So here we are, I trigger it again, and yeah, okay, the breakpoint's been hit, and yeah, sure enough, the new sensor data is null. So I definitely have a null pointer problem. Let's have a look at the references for this code. It looks like it's referenced by another class. Let's take a look there, and oh yeah, my bad. I've left a to-do in the code saying put something more sensible. So that's fine. I can now stop the debugger because I know where the problem is, and I can switch to my live update feature, which lets me update the code live on Kubernetes. So my VS Code environment is just attaching to the QA platform, and once I've attached, I can then go in and take a look at the code and put in a quick fix. So let's replace that null with something more sensible. I'm going to create some new sensor data here. So I add new sensor data, generate some of that. Okay, there we go. So I save that file. It automatically goes straight to the QA environment on Kubernetes. I don't have to do anything. And now I can just wait for that to restart. So it's restarting my Spring Boot application. And now it's started, I can try it again. So I click my button, and yeah, cool. I'm getting sensor data coming through. So there it is, it's fixed. Didn't stop the folks in QA from getting on with their day. And now I can take that piece of code and put it straight into Git, and it's fixed.